Hey everybody, Randy, Myers Homestead Timber Products. Today, I am going to put a new blade on this LX55 WoodMizer saw and start sawing some logs up. Got a pine log here, two more over there. I have red oak and white oak, and then I have sweet gum over there, which I know is, people say is a problem to mill up twist and bends and everything else. Nice cool 100 degrees out here in Texas. We'll get started, put this blade on this LX55.
Ain't gonna be happy about that. Probably this guy down here. I feel it buzzing around my head too. It is a warm one today. All right, I'm gonna start this thing. See if this blade seats itself. Let's see if I can get her started. I wish I had one of them colors that would fire right up on the first try like everybody said.
Thank you.
just tightens up the blade. Just they give you a special ratchet that goes on there. They got a provision right here on the back. It's just a like a bolt that's welded on there. Has a wing nut, the washer, so you don't lose it. Secure it there. All right. Yeah, got it going. New blades on. I got to do something with this log. It sits up further on the back. I don't know if I have to get the tractor out, lift it up, maybe put a board underneath there to get it sticking up higher. I think it's some good lumber out of here. I don't want to waste this. But anyway, once I get all that done, I'll come back and show you what I'm doing. All right, today I just had to turn this log over. We'll see how it goes. I'm no professional at this by any means. It is hot. It is humid. I'm sweating like crazy. We're going to be careful today. Good way to get hurt here out in Texas. Got several projects we need to do. I need to build a shelter for this particular sawmill here. And then I need to get the wood crates away from the house and build some a shelter over there to put them underneath and the wood splitter. So that's what we're going to do today. I have to get this stop up. Alright. I just have to watch those stops there. Maybe I'll put it down a little bit. Probably get better out here so we don't saw into them. First one. Then we can run at 180. All right. Sure is hot. Here we go. No pressure.
Water's blocked up. All right. We got the coolant lines blocked up on this one. I'm gonna go in and get some wire, cool off a little bit, get a drink, come back out, fix it up. All right, I got a wire. I stuck it up the Luba tube left on the blade. There was some mud dauber's nest inside of it. Got that off, taken care of, got the blade back on. I'm going to go ahead and fire it up, make sure that blade's seated, and go from there.
We have to go in and get some more lubrication. Just water. I use dish soap in it. I don't have any, people use pine saw and stuff. If I had pine saw, I'd use it. But I don't have any, so. But I'm also gonna look at this to see what size it is. I'd like to get some 2x4s, because if that's a, and then again, I wouldn't mind having a beam either. So I don't know. I need to decide what I'm gonna do with this, and then I'll come back and let you guys know. All right, everybody. I have measured this board and come to the conclusion that it's 10 inches this way and it's 4 inches that way. So I need 2x10s. So I'm just gonna cut this board exactly in half, get true dimension, 2x10s, and be done with the night. And then tomorrow, the next video, we'll be cutting sweet gum. I'm gonna cut some sweet gum. Never done it. But anyway, 2x10, two 2x10s. Fill up my bottle. Here we go.
Couple 2x10s.
It is so hot and humid, man. It is unbelievable. These things weigh a ton wet. So, but it will be needed. Let me go to make the overhang for the wood and splitter, and the overhang of the shelter for this here LX55 WoodMizer. Do a little walk around here. I want to show you something. Everybody who has an LX55 WoodMizer pretty much should ought to know this by now, but if you haven't figured it out, these bottles do not have air holes in them. Just drill you a little air hole in the top. It doesn't bother you when you fill it because you tip it up, and it may leak out a little bit when you go to put it in, but it's no big deal. Do yourself a big, huge favor and do that. But that's that. This is all the oak that I'm gonna mill up into some boards. And I'm not afraid to use oak boards building stuff either, because I'm not gonna waste my timber. And you can see this is the two pine logs that I got. I have some massive, massive oak trees right there that would make great mantelpieces. I don't know if they'll fit on this LX55 or not, but we're going to try to put one on there one of these days, and I'll make a video of it, and I'm going to make some big mantles. But that's that. And anybody that's ever familiar with sweet gum, everybody knows that it's, hard to mill. But anyway, see these? That's how you know when you got sweet gum. These balls fall from sweet gum trees right here. But we're gonna find out what this wood is all about. I heard it's sturdy. I heard the drier it gets, the harder it gets, if you can keep it straight. But these are the massive logs right there of a sweet gum tree that fell off that particular tree, which is a massive, massive sweet gum. So we'll see. There's another piece of it over there. We are gonna snag some, and we're gonna try to make beams out of them. I figure if I can make some beams, they might stay straight. I don't know. With all the wood down here, that tree fell over in the hurricane. Look at that pine tree right there. That thing is huge. Huge. I would love to have that. I got one more pine tree, if you can see it right there, that has fallen through the woods. One of these days, when it's not so hot, I will yard that thing out of there. And this is the sweet gum. That's the base where it fell. The hurricane did damage to it. And I don't know what I'm gonna do with that. I'm just gonna have to cut that up. But these, I'm gonna make beams out of them, because I really don't feel like trying to figure out what it's gonna be like to make a board out of sweet gum when better sawyers than I, there's that pine way over there, better sawyers than I have had problems milling these things and keeping them straight. But as you can see, I got a lot of woods, and when those trees fall, you can tell that one's dead. I would love to cut that thing down. when trees fall, I'm gonna mill them up. Here's a look from the backside of what I got going on. I got trees everywhere. But I am going to try to mill as much as I can in the next 3 or 4 days and get this stuff drying and go from there. But I will do a video on milling those sweet gums, because I haven't seen too many videos of anybody with an LX55 or, and for that fact, any kind of sawmill, Woodland Mills, WoodMizer, any of the other ones on YouTube, mill any sweet gum. But I am curious. I do have a bunch of sweet gum because it just grows naturally. I mean, it drops seeds everywhere. But look at these logs. These are the mantles. Dude is 36 inches side to side. Massive. A rarity around here, cherry logs. I had one cherry tree. That's oak right there in the center of it, but right there is cherry. That's cherry, and that's going to be smoking wood, I guess. I was going to mill it, but it looks pretty raunchy to be milling, so I think I'll cut it up. It's pretty punky right there, but I think I'll cut it up and smoke something with it. There's another one of them big oaks, big red oak, I think. Got the stuff growing on it. Cracking out. I don't paint them. I know you're supposed to. I just don't. I don't got time for that. We'll mill it, see what happens. Like I said, big amateur. So, but after I get all those over there all milled up, I'm coming after these big logs to get them out of the way. So, my wife can ride the mower and mow our grass. That's for sure. I don't know if you guys ever had a magnolia tree in your yard, but you can tell the magnolia right there, it drops leaves like crazy. Branches will just fall out of that thing. You gotta those look like pecan trees, but they're not. So those are hickory trees. There's a hickory tree there, some sort of oak. And a scraggly hickory tree. Anyway, that's the deal there. That's the old WoodMizer LX55. Just sawed me up some pine logs. Some of these end pieces. Make some benches or some seats or something out of them. I don't know. I ain't figured it out. But I got me a couple of 5 or 6, 7, 8 pieces of siding. I mean, they're not but a half inch thick. I plan on using them after they dry inside, because we got some issues. Not thinking very well. I was doing the splitting my wood underneath my hill. You remember the video where I moved those up there? But guess what? Termites love it. They got in the house. So I've been fighting termites like crazy. So there'll be a video on me showing you the damage on that or whatever. Anyway, this is a WoodMizer LX55. Just got the pine. Going after sweet gum next video. Thanks for watching, guys. If you'd hit subscribe. Like, once you leave some comments, it'd be much appreciated. And we'll catch you on the next one.